Hello everybody and welcome back to Bee Joy in the Kitchen. I'm Bee Joy and this is my kitchen. And today I'm really excited to share a recipe with you for roasted carrot salad with a chamoy sauce. Now chamoy sauce, it hails from Mexico and it hits all the high notes. Sweet, spicy, sour, and salty. So it's really quite an explosion on the tongue. So let's get started. Carrots, you know, one of my now favorites that I never ate until I was like 18 years old, but use them all the time now. We're going to start with the carrots, and what we want to do is cut these probably about 3.5 inch by about 1/2 inch batons. I'll give you a little bit of an example here. I'm going to cut off the top and the bottom of the carrot. You can save those for later use in a stock if you'd like. I'm going to cut this guy in about half. These are the biggest carrots I've ever seen. I saw them at the farmer's market and I go, oh my God, I've got to have those. And we need about 2 pounds of them to begin with. Well, to begin and end with, really. And here we have the batons that we're going to use. So just wanted to give you a little sample of what those are going to look like and how to cut them. Again, always remember to keep your paws out of the way of the knife. And I'm not going to look up at you right now. I'm going to concentrate on looking down so that I don't cut myself. Okay, now we're going to take these, and now I got them in a large bowl. You want to have plenty of space to have them move around. We're going to add to that 3 tablespoons of my favorite, Newman's Own Organic olive oil. And then 4 1/4 teaspoons, which is basically a little over a tablespoon. 4 teaspoons like that. Just checking on this too. This is from my, I should mention that as well. There's the maple syrup in there, about 1 1/4 teaspoons of salt, along with a good grind of pepper. And then we're going to take these and mix them up. And you know how I like to use my hands. And it was funny because recently I was looking at some other home chefs like myself, home cooks, and looking at their YouTubes, and they use their hands too. So I just loved it. I felt right at home looking at their recipes. Alrighty, we're going to put those on prepared baking sheets that I've got. I think we only probably need one. I've got some parchment paper on here. Just like that. Spread them out. So nobody's touching anybody. And I, like I said, I think I can put these all in one sheet pan. I'm going to put that, while I was waiting for you, I had my oven warming up to 500 degrees. And I'm going to go ahead and put this in the oven for about 18 minutes. All right. So that's as easy as can be to roast carrots. I just love roasting vegetables. It really sweetens them up, I think. All right. And then while we're waiting for those to roast, what we want to do is make our chamoy sauce. So I should mention before I go any further where I've got this recipe from. I did not make it up. This is from my new favorite book, Flavor, by Yotam Ottolenghi, and I'm just crazy about all of his recipes. This whole book is about vegetables and sauces. So what we're going to do for our chamoy sauce, like I said, hails from Mexico. We're going to put in 1/2 cup of dried apricots, and I've got the kind that are not bright orange, so they're without sulfur. We got that. Next, we're going to put in 1 teaspoon. Just a little teaspoon of maple syrup. I didn't mention about the maple syrup, but I just love Shady Maple, organic maple syrup. It's always been my favorite. Not always easy to find, but it's always been my favorite. Okay, we've got that. 2 teaspoons of sumac that you can get at specialty spice stores. This is what it looks like. It's red, very dark red, in fact. So sumac, and also often used in the Middle Eastern dishes as well. We've got 3 tablespoons of lime juice that I squeezed while I was waiting for you. Now, you gotta see the lime thing though. This lime juice came from these, and you say, Bee Joy, those look like lemons. Well, it turns out friends of ours have this beautiful Persian lime tree in their yard, and they brought us yesterday, like just like a whole big bag full. This is only about half of them. So I thought, well, I'm gonna go for those. And they're, I don't know, just a little bit tangier for some reason, but they're really good. All right, so we've got that, our lime juice. Then we're going to put in some, I'm using red chili flakes. You can also use Aleppo pepper chili flakes if you like. I had Aleppo pepper, but I only had ground. So that's why I chose chili flakes, because it wanted a flaky thing. And small garlic clove right here. You don't have to chop it or any of that. You do have to take off its jacket. And then two more tablespoons of my favorite olive oil. Newman's Own Organic. So we're going to put that in there. And just a quarter teaspoon of salt. I'm gonna pop that in and let this, one of those, get your earmuffs out, cover your ears. We're gonna get this going so that it becomes almost a paste. I put it in the small bowl of the food processor up here. Yeah, I'm going to just let it go just a little bit because I want it a little bit less pasty. And there we have it. A little less pasty than it was. Take a show of it for you. It's fairly pasty here. I'm going to come up close so that you can see what it looks like. It's actually a paste. And what we're going to do is when those carrots come out in another 15, I think we're about 14 minutes or so, we're going to show you the next step, which is to cover the carrots in that. So I'll be back in just a second. Okay, here we are back with our carrots that I roasted at a 500 degree oven for about 18 minutes. I just pulled them out, put them in here. While you're roasting them, the best thing to do is halfway through at about 8 minutes, go ahead and mix them around on the platter, on the sheet pan, and then turn your sheet pan around. So about 8 minutes one way and 8 minutes the other way, toss them around to get a nice even roast to them. Really pretty looking. And don't let them get too soft. So depending on how your oven runs, you can kind of be the judge of that. All right, we're ready to add our chamoy paste to the carrots. Now they're all, everybody's nice and hot, and I'm not gonna go ahead and put all this in because it doesn't look like in this case it's gonna take all of it. It's gonna take part of it. This is looking really, really yummy, gotta say. All right, and you see why you don't want the carrots to be too soft, because you don't want them to, be mushy, let's just say. Who likes mushy carrots? Not me. All right, I'm going to add just a touch more, but as you can see, I think I used about, just about half of what we put together here. And you can use this for another use. The other thing about chamoy is that, let's say you don't have apricots or you don't like apricots, you can use any kind of dried fruit. You could use a dried fig, or you could use raisins, or let's see, we've got dates. A lot of different opportunities if you're not an apricot person. I like apricots personally because they have a little bit more of a little zing to them. All right, so we've got these all nicely mixed around with the chamoy. We're gonna let them set up now for about 20 minutes, just so that they can marinate in the chamoy, and then we've got some additions that we're going to put in there after. So I'll see you soon. Alrighty, so these guys have been marinating around for about 20 minutes, and they're looking really, really fine. Let me give you a close-up shot of what they look like in there with their chamoy. So the end, this is kind of a three-parter. So the end comes when we're going to put in 1/4 cup of dill, 1/2 cup of mint leaves, and 8 apricots sliced thin. Again, if you're more of a raisin fan, put your raisins in there, or dates or what have you, and we're going to mix these around so that they've got really quite the array. It's really, if you can tell from here, it's very, very colorful and so tasty. I will say I cheated and I tasted one of the carrots, and it's got a little bit of a nice spicy bite to it from the chili peppers. Yeah. Oh, this is nice. Okay, so let's put it in our serving platter. Our serving dish right here. Get it all in there like that. Nice. Whoa, this is really, really pretty. All right. And then to top it all off, what we're going to do is put 1/4 cup of almonds. I use raw almonds. You can use toasted almonds, salted almonds, whatever. I like just plain raw. 2 teaspoons of that beautiful lime juice. And then about 4 1/2 teaspoons of, which is all, just a little over a tablespoon. Just shake it around a little bit of the Newman's olive oil. And here we have our roasted carrot salad with chamoy. I'm going to serve that room temperature for dinner tonight. And I might have to take another little taste of it before we have it for dinner. Maybe like right now. That is so good. Delicious. Okay, so I'm not talking with my mouth full. What I wish for you this coming week is to be joy in your own kitchen. Give this salad a try. Let me know what you think. And we need to continue to wear our masks, wash our hands, social distance, and be safe out there. And I'll see you next time. Thanks for coming by today.